God is a way, if you read the Bible, to use old bunch of things, old bunch of people, all the stories you read, things, people that are completely insignificant, that are small. He uses small things, sample things, specific things. He uses things that you would never think of using all throughout the Bible, because he wants to show, no. When you are weak, I am strong. I love you. You're valuable to me. I put things in your hand. I lead you. I guide you. It's like Moses was telling God all the excuses and telling him, well, how will they believe me? Look, who am I? Even though God had told him, tell him that I am. He was telling God, well, who I am, little old me. The foolish things of the world to confound the wise. Who am I? God, you know, he said, what's that you have in your hand? It was a rod. It was just a rod. God used the rod in this man who thought he was so small. He was trying to teach him something about humility and obedience. Just obey me. If I tell you to go there, if I send you there, if I tell you to speak to this person or share with that person, whatever I lead you to do, it's how great I am, not how great you are. So I'm sending you. He said, well, I have a rod. So he said, throw it on the ground. Throw it on the ground, it becomes a serpent. Moses just flies back. Not because it's a serpent, but to see the power of God change what was in his hand that he was so used in what he was doing, taking care of the sheep. He was used to this rod just being a sample rod in God's hand. Then he told him, pick it back up by the tail. Pick the snake by the tail, because he was going to defeat the head on the cross, but that's... And he picks it up and it turns into a rod again. Small things. He uses Gideon with 300 men. Small. Sample. 300 men. To come against 32,000. When you see all the stories in the Bible, it just, because I want you to hear this so that you can pay attention to the voice of God and step out, do what he tells you to do, because the battle will try to stop you, but my God, and you know, when I say do what he tells you to do, I'm not talking about big things, I'm talking about no matter how insignificant it looks like. It's not our job to be God and decide. We don't see, you will never know one word that you shared about Jesus, how far it will go. You don't know. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 3, so 6, 7, he says, Paulos planted, I watered, but God gave the increase. He says, so neither Apollos or Paul is anything. But it's God who gives the increase. God, even when he tells you to pray for someone, you don't know. You don't know what God does with that prayer. You have no clue. You know, there's something about obedience, about us sharing what God puts in our heart, wherever we are, that we don't know how many people are born again, how many souls come to the kingdom, because someone that might have appeared to be small, sample, insignificant. What about David? David just had one slingshot. It's one slaying in front of a big giant. You see God in Luke for, let's see, who's been working out long enough, who has been sharpening their sword, who's got the most artillery. No, I believe that he uses the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, because he's trying to teach his people that his wisdom is mighty, his wisdom is powerful, that he is wise, his ways are above our ways, that he does that so mankind can give him praise, honor, and glory, so that mankind can say thank you. All to you is the praise. All to you is the glory. Thank you, my God, for bringing these people to the Lord. Thank you for healing this one, saving this one, freeing this one, delivering this one. And my God, thank you that you love us, all of us, and that if you can do it for this one, surely you can do it for me, my God, my God, my God. It does those things. They use one slingshot on the giant. Do you know how much the youth of this generation need messages like that? I wish I would have heard this when I was young. I wish I would have heard this before I thought I had no value, so that I took in and did whatever. Because I didn't respect myself. I didn't have any value. But when you understand that each of us not only share the life of the Lord, not only share what he has done for us, but the talents he has given us, everything that he has placed in our lives, God used the oil that was left in a jar of someone that was thinking, I have nothing left, me and my sons, we are about to die. Absolutely nothing. You have to see God, because you will go through moments that you might not even have any provisions. There's no way you can figure out with your mind how God can do a thing. You know, story after story after story in the Bible, God repeats his way to show people, look at me, believe in the impossible. She's about to die, and he said, do you have any oil? I just have this little bit in this jar. I just have a few drops. I have a few drops. This is not going to feed us. This is not going to do anything, she tells Elisha. And Elisha says, go get some vessels. Do you understand that not only he teaches us that that God uses what is small, simple, insignificant, but then he gives us sample instructions. That you're thinking, what? You didn't hear me, Elisha. I only have a few drops of oil. You're telling me to go get vessels to fill them up? What do you mean? But you see, there's sample steps of obedience. So she goes, get the vessels, and they get multiplied. As long as they were vessels, the provisions was coming. It kept coming. My God, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. He sees that the multitude is hungry. And all that's available is 5 loaves of bread, 2 little fishes, 5,000 people. 5,000 men, so maybe 15,000 people to feed. He tells his disciples, just like he's telling us today. He tells them, sit down. Seat the people in groups of 50. And he gives each of them the bread and a little piece of fish to multiply it. as they distribute it. Jesus, you didn't hear us. All we have, we only have this. God is like, but I have everything that is needed. I am the great I am. I have everything. I am the God of increase. I am the God of multiplication. I am the God that stretches what you have. I am the God that heals you. I am the God who saves you. I am the God. All I need you to do is pay attention to my instructions. Simple things that he tells them to do.